save and save our souls, O Lord. Holy God, with thy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. O God, with thy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. O God, with thy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now and ever, and unto the age of ages. Amen.
Thank you. peace, let us pray to the
Lord.
For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the
Lord.
For this holy house and for those with faith, reverence, and the fear of God entered therein, let us pray to the
Lord.
Father Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood that he had in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the
Lord.
For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the
Lord. The
President of the United States, for all civil authorities and for armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Joshua, Ronnie, Adam, Andrew, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Connor, and Skyler, let us pray to the
Lord. Have mercy.
For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the
Lord.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those under persecution for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the
Lord.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Unto all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
God is our Lord, who has shown us light. What a sin is he that comes. O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance are all holy and immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, ever Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto you, Christ our God.
Yeah.
mercy upon us and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance are all holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious, but he said, help us never, Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Afterward, he appeared to the 11 themselves as they sat at table, and he upbraided them for their
unbelief and hardness of heart, because they had not believed those who saw him after he had risen. And he said to them, Go into all the world and preach the gospel to the whole creation. He who believes and is baptized will be saved, but he who does not believe will be condemned. And these signs will accompany those who believe. In my name they will cast out demons. They will speak in new tongues. They will pick up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it will not hurt them. They will lay their hands on the sick and they will recover. So then the Lord, after he had spoken to them, was taken up into heaven and sat down at the right hand of God. And they went forth and preached everywhere, the Lord working with them, confirming the word by the signs that attended it. Amen.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
In that we have beheld the resurrection of Christ, let us bow down and call before the Holy Lord Jesus, the only sinless one. I cross thee and glorify the Lord Christ, and I will pray and glorify. For thou art our God, who is known to them that are beside thee. Call upon my name. O come, my God, and our wise will have passion. For both the cause of joy comes to all the world, everlasting Lord of the sage and resurrection. For in that he has murdered God for us, he has destroyed death by death.
Have mercy on me, O God, according to that great mercy, according to the multitude of that compassion. Blot out my transgression. Walk me thoroughly from my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sin, for I know my iniquity and my sin is ever before me. Give to me how my sin is done this evil before me, that thou my soul is glad and resurrected. In her bed that thou art cut. For behold, I was in iniquity, this is in my mother's family. For behold, thou hast left true, that it is a sweet thing that thy wisdom hast thou made manifest unto me. Thou shalt sprinkle me with this if it actually made clean. Thou shalt wash me, and actually made white wool. Thou shalt make me even joy and gladness, the bones that be humble and shall rejoice. Turn thy face away from my sins and blot out all my iniquities. Create me to be not in a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from them, for instance, take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joys I have not made known. And with thy governing spirit establish me. I shall teach transgressions thy ways, and be a God who shall come back unto thee. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, with thou bought my salvation. Lord, thou shalt open my lips, my mouth shall give her bread. For if thou hadst thy sacrifice, thy gift, hold her daughter, thou shalt not be broken. And sacrifice unto God with brokenness. With a broken spirit, heart that is broken and humble, God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, in thy good pleasure, and let the multitude of evil die. Then shall thou be thankful for thy sacrifice, with oblation and whole broken offering. Then shall they offer the love upon thine altar.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, through the intercessions of the apostles, O thou who art merciful, pour out all the multitude of our intercessions. O thou in heaven, answer my ages, O ages of
exalt the Lord of Orthodox Christians, set down upon us thy rich mercies. The intercessions of our All Immaculate Lady Theotokos, Never Virgin Mary, whose nativity we now celebrate, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplications of thy honorable, glorious prophet, Warner and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, all laudable apostles, Peter and Paul, and of all thy holy apostles, of our fathers among the saints, great hierarchs and ecumenical teachers, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasios, Cyril, and John the Merciful, Patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra, Skiridon of Demetrius, Victorious of Pentapolis, the window of herds, of our fathers among the saints, Tikhon, Patriarch of Moscow, Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the Trophimer, Demetrius the Myrrh Streamer, Theodore the Soldier, Theodore the General, and Venus the Winter Worker, of the higher martyrs, Ignatius, Gadir of Antioch, Alampos, Eleutherios, of the holy, great women martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kiriaki, Fratini, Marina, Prescov, and Irene, of the holy, glorious, right, victorious martyrs, of our venerable godparents, fathers who shone in the ascetic life, St. Barnabas, the patron protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the martyrs, Minidora, Metrodora, Nicodora, the Empress, Plucia, Lucia, and Peter, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all thy saints, we beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of us sinners who make our supplications unto thee. Have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and save us.
There are many bones as having strong.
Thank you. Thank you.
Master.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. In peace let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the
Lord.
For the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the
Lord.
For this holy house and for those who with faith, reverence, and the fear of God entered therein, let us pray to the
Lord.
For our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the
Lord.
For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the
Lord.
For the President of the United States, for all civil authorities, and for armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Joshua, Ronnie, Adam, Benjamin, Andrew, Thaddeus, Tyler, and Connor, let us pray to the
Lord.
For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the
Lord.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those under persecution for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the
Lord.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Remember, O Lord, David and all his meekness, though we heard it of it at Ephrath, the Ephrathah, we have found it in the plains of the wood.
The intercessions of the Theotokos sustain your saints.
Not be shaken. God shall help her right early in the morning.
Through the intercessions of the Theotokos, sustain your saints.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen.
Through the intercessions of the Theotokos, sustain your saints.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us. Keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance, our Holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious, take this, O Christ, Virgin Mary. All the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Thine
is the majesty and
save us, have mercy upon us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. All in your remembrance, our Holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious, all the saints, let us commend ourselves together and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Stand upright.
Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ, O Son of God, who art risen from the
thank you.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Holy art thou, our God, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever.
And unto ages of ages.
Brethren, see with what large letters I am writing to you with mine own hand. It is those who want to make a good showing in the flesh that would compel you to be circumcised, and not only in order that they may not be persecuted for the cross of Christ. For even those who receive circumcision do not themselves keep the law, but they desire to have you circumcised that they may glory in your flesh. But far be it from me to glory except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, by which the world has been crucified to me, and I to the world. For neither circumcision counts for anything, nor uncircumcision, but a new creation. Peace and mercy be upon all who walk by this rule, upon the Israel of God. Henceforth let no man trouble me, for I bear on my body the marks of Jesus. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with your spirit, brethren. Amen.
Peace be to thee that readeth.
Glory to thee, O Lord.
heaven but he who is descended from heaven, the Son of Man. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God sent his Son into the world, not to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him.
Clothed himself in it when he became man. Humility and love. These are the infallible tests, if you will, of a life that has lived in Christ. If you want to love, you must learn to become humble. And to love as God loves, to act. The scandal, you know, Christianity has always been the cross because of what it says about God. The cross means that God, the all-powerful, is the humblest and most compassionate of all. You know, God humbled himself to rescue us. He became a human being in order to save us from death, sin, and the devil. And this he did, not by becoming some sort of Superman, some sort of Hercules, you know, by mortal combat, by force and by power, by show of might, but by humbling himself, by opening himself to ridicule, to, you know, rejection by family and friend alike, and ultimately by the most serious injustice, torture, and death at the hands of the very creature upon which his love was born and manifest, knowing that he would suffer at our hands and suffer great indignity, he came anyway. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. Another surprising thing is that God not only loves us, but he also honors us and respects us. Here's one of the teachings of one of the greatest Orthodox saints, St. Gregory of Nyssa, on this subject. He says, know to what extent the Creator has honored you above all creation. This is really interesting. I was really struck by this when I read it. The sky is not an image of God, nor is the moon, nor the sun, nor the beauty of the stars, nor anything else that can be seen in creation. You alone have been made in the image of the reality that transcends all understanding, the likeness of imperishable beauty, the imprint of true divinity, the recipient of beatitude, the seal of the true light. When you turn to him, you become that which he himself is. That's a, you know, that's an amazing thing. We're so used to people saying, oh, you know, I don't go to church. But I like to go out in the wilderness. I go to Yosemite or, you know, whatever. Some wild place, El Segundo. And because there I find the beauty of God. And all we can really say to that is, well, yeah, that's nice. But if you don't find the beauty of God in your neighbor, in the person sitting next to you right now, then you're blind. You know? You're just blind. You don't know God. And you don't know his love. There is nothing so great among beings that can be compared with the greatness of humanity made in the image of God. God is able to measure the whole heaven with a span. The earth and the sea are enclosed in the hollow of his hand. And although he is so great, he holds all creation in the palm of his hand. And you hold him in the palm of your hand when you come forth for Holy Communion. Well, you don't actually hold them in your mouth, but same idea. He dwells in you, not just in communion, but certainly in communion. But he dwells in you through grace of holy baptism. He moves in you without constraint. For he has said, I will live and move among them. And also the kingdom of heaven is within you. Your God is present. Your God has honored you, not only by being made in his image, but by filling you with himself. He who cannot be contained is within you. And he has such great love for us. And if so, should we not love one another? It is inevitable that the message moves constantly back and forth between these two poles in the Holy Scriptures. God loves us, so we must love. God is merciful, so we must be merciful. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Always going back and forth, because of God, we must, you know. It is from this understanding that there's no way to separate devotion to Christ, devotion to God, devotion to the cross, from devotion to one another, to be devoted to one another, to love one another. There's no way to separate that, except in the darkened heart of men, but certainly not in the scriptures and not in the minds of the saints. And it's from this understanding that you cannot separate God from your brother, not from some silly, faddish political correctness or so-called tolerance, but it is from this understanding of your brother as, you know, represents to you God, that true love and compassion flows. It flows really from the heart of God himself. So if it is at all our desire to know God, and I hope it is, I hope that's the reason we're here, and to love God, then we absolutely must love one another. There's no escape. Oh, come on, isn't there an easier way? No. If you want to love God, you have to love your brother. Isn't this what the scripture says over and over? He who loveth not knoweth not God, for God is love. Your brother, your sister, your neighbor, your friend, your enemy, your boss. Oh, that's redundant, sorry. the person sitting next to you or behind you, we must love one another the same way that God loves us, not with feels, but with incarnate action. We must pray for one another. We must serve one another. We must honor, respect, and even cherish one another. Think of the great good that God has done, granting us his image, filling us with himself, loving us, dying for us, rising again for us. This is how we must love one another, somehow, as much as we are humanly able. We must discover that in your neighbor resides God. You don't have to go to the high mountain. You don't have to go to Tibet or wherever. You just have to look at your friend, your neighbor, your co-worker, your fellow parishioner, and see God. You know, they have been saying in the monasteries on Athos, there are no mirrors for the monks to look in. They all look alike anyway. So. They always say, if you want to see yourself, look in the face of your brother. And I think this goes beyond just the fact that they all look alike. The fact that you really, you know, you want to focus on God. Whatever you see in the mirror, I guess, is sort of an accident. Well, in my case, especially, so it looks like the mirror had an accident. But we look really for the image of God. We should look for that always in others, and even in ourselves. We show our love for God, or lack of love, in how we love or don't love others. Do we care about them? Oh, yeah, again, I'm not talking about happy feelings. Yeah, I kind of like everybody here. No, but do I love everybody here? Do I pray for everybody here? If someone has a need, does it become my need? If someone has a hurt, does it become my hurt? And so on. If someone has a joy, do I rejoice with them? We show devotion to God and how we are devoted to one another. You know, I don't think it would occur to any one of us to come up here and stand before one of these beautiful icons and curse or spit at this image, and yet we'll do that to the image of God in others. We curse our neighbors, our friends. We speak vile about them. We're blind. We don't see that they really are the true icon. This is just wood and paint. The flesh and blood is the true icon of God. May we, our devotion to God, always be unsullied, unconfused, without hypocrisy, and truly motivated by love. May we love one another as God loves us. The glory of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us. Keep us, O God, by thy grace, wisdom.
That by your voice, by thy might, may we ascribe glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. the President of the United States and all civil authorities and our armed forces everywhere. The Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. The Orthodox servants of God, especially for those suffering because of the hurricane in Florida, for Maryland, for Brielle, for the Archpriest Wayne, for Sony and Sona and Gary, Carlos, Cindy, John and Lori, Mary, David, Kevin, for Michelle, Mary, Claire, Christina, Lauren, Serena, Autumn, Stephanie, Taylor, Lori, Kelsey, Maggie, Stacy, for Margaret, Tom, and Peggy, the Lord God grant them mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon, and remission of their sins. Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. Orthodox servants of God departed this life, especially for Maria, Mary Sue, for Susan, and for Walter. The Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Spirit now.
Let us love one another, that with one accord we may confess.
Thank you.
sufficient for you and for me, for the remission of sins.
Having in remembrance, therefore, this saving commandment, and all those things which have come to pass for us, the cross, the grave, the resurrection on the third day, the ascension into heaven, the session at the right hand, and the second, the glorious end. Thine own of thine own we offer unto thee, in behalf of all and for all.
Savior Jesus Christ be with you all.
Amen.
Holy things are for the holy.
Holy is holy, holy.
voluntary, a word and a deed, a knowledge and ignorance, and make me worthy to partake without condemnation of thy immaculate mysteries, unto remission of my sins, and unto life everlasting. Amen. On thy blessed supper, O Son of God, accept me today as a communicant, for I will not speak of thy mysteries to my enemies. Neither will I give thee a kiss as to Jesus, but like the evil I confess thee. Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. Not as a judgment, nor in a condemnation, be my partaking of thy holy mysteries, O Lord, but as the healing of soul and body.
With the fear of God,
with faith and love draw near.
Thank you.
God, save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
Our souls and bodies, for that thou hast saved this day to feed
guard our life, may firm our steps. Through the prayers and intercessions of the glorious Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary and of all their saints. For thou art our sanctification, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace. Sanctifies those who put their trust in thee. Save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Preserve the fullness of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy house. Glorify them and recompense by thy divine power. And forsake us not, O hope on thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to the priests, to all civil authorities, to our armed forces, and to all the people. For every good and perfect gift is from above, and cometh down from thee, the Father of lights. And unto thee we ascribe glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen.
Let the spirits of the righteous make perfect. Give rest to the soul of thy servant, our Savior, and preserve it in that life of blessedness which is with thee. For thou who lovest mankind, in the place of the rest, O Lord, where all thy saints repose, give rest also to the soul of thy servant. For thou only lovest mankind. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Thou art our God, who descended into hell, and loosed the bonds of those who were there. Thyself give rest also to the soul of thy servant, both now and ever and into ages of ages. Amen. O Virgin, unknown, pure, and immaculate, who without stain didst bring forth God, intercede for the salvation of her soul.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to thy great goodness, we pray thee. Hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Then we pray for the repose of the soul of thy servant Susan, departed this life, that thou wilt pardon her every transgression, both voluntary and involuntary.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
That the Lord God will establish your souls with a just repose, the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, the remission of our sins, let us ask of Christ our immortal King and our God.
Grant this, O Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God of spirits and of all flesh, who has trampled down death and made powerless the devil, and given life to thy will, to thou the same Lord, thy give rest to the soul of thy departed servant Suzanne, in a place of brightness, a place of verdure, a place of repose, whence all sickness, sorrow, and sighing have fled away. Pardon every sin which she hath committed, whether by word or deed or thought, for thou art good and lovest mankind. For there is no one who lives and sins not, and thou only art without sin. Thy righteousness is to all eternity, and thy law is true. The power of the resurrection and the life and the repose of thy departed servant Susanna, O Christ our God, and to thee we ascribe glory, together with thy Father who is from everlasting, and in all the legal and life in the spirit of my endeavor, and unto ages of the ages.
Amen.
It's still a blessed day of Topos, who are most holy, save us.
O Lord of love, and the cherubim, and the uncomparable glorious, and the seraphim, thou who without stain bearest God the Word, and our true Theotokos, we magnify thee.
Glory to thee, O Christ, our God, and our Father, glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Father, bless.
May Christ, our true God, through who have dominion over the living and the dead, through the intercessions of his all immaculate and all blameless Holy Father, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, and of all the saints, establish the soul of his departed servant Suzanne, departing this life in his holy mansions, and number her among the just, and have mercy upon us for as much as he is good and love us mankind.
Thank you.
Christ our God, have mercy on us.